Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we are going to talk about this two-tone cross and the most easy way to make this illusion of crossing over type of a design. Are you ready? Let's get started. This video is not including the stone setting part as I have been talk about this in my other video. And also if you would like to check on the detail on all type of a stone setting, you can check on my course that's online. I will also put the link at the description below. Let's take a look on how to model the cross. The cross is actually coming all kind of proportion. I don't really have a specific one in mind, but I'm just gonna draw some sort of a reference for me to start with. So what I do first is I need to start drawing the line. I'm going to use the arc tool and snapping into this endpoint and endpoint, and you want to come over and cross that point over there. As you can see, I'm going to have another one cross over here. So we are going to draw another one, snapping into the endpoint and come over something like that. If that is not something that you like, you do need to move them up and down. You can actually edit your control point to move it to the desired place that you have. So once we have this one, I'm going to using the mirror command and move it to the other side and double check if that is a proportion and everything that you like. For example, I may want to have those two points going just up a little bit so it's more central there. Okay, so once we have this, we are going to creating the profile. I'm not building the model in certain type of a proportion, but you also need to make sure that the casting will survive. You cannot go like too thin on the certain type of a design. So the best way to do is drawing the profile on the side. As many of you probably already know, I like to use conic corners on the rectangle. So right click on this icon. I'm going to start drawing something like this. Okay, so it is more of the cushion there. In order to snap it correctly into my cross, I'm going to find out where's the center. Two ways you can do it. You can first get a line right there and put the dot right at the midpoint. That's one way to do it. The other way to do it, we can go into the analyze and you have mass property, and then you area, click on the area centroid. Then you click on this curve and I will give you a dot right in the middle. So let's go ahead to group them. The second one, this is the first curve that we have, which is the middle profile. It's going to be thicker. I'm just simply going to make a copy with the gumbo and make it slightly smaller, and that will be the end. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a bunch of a copy. I'm going to make using the copy command, and I'm going to select this group for the smaller one, and that's snapping into the point right at the center, and we're going to make the copy on all the end there. So, and here, here, and here. All right, at this point, we don't really worry about the orientation. Yes, we'll change it later. The second one, we also gonna make a copy. So I'm going to have one over here, which is this one is gonna go a little bit higher. Any part of the higher one, you wanna have it right in the middle. And then the other one probably will be somewhere around here, and then somewhere around here. So I just go ahead and change the color in red. It's easier for you to see. Now let's go take a look on the top view. Very important part is we need to make sure that all the cross section is 90 degrees toward to the sweep direction. Roughly, it doesn't have to be super 90 degrees, but we want to get something like this. So kind of using the gumbo to change the direction for all of them. And the one on the top and the bottom, I actually want to have them 90 degrees exact. So what I do is I use a gumball and arc and hold my shift command, so they will be 100% 90 degrees to the construction plane. Okay, so now we have something like this. We probably want to think about when this coming over here, it might be touching. If you want to set the stone, you might need to move this one in a little bit. So at least you will have some room for the stone setting or something like that. So we could move this out a little bit and the same one moving this guy out a little bit.Alright, so now we have everything set up. We are going to use the sweep 1 command. So sweep 1, and make sure every time you have a record history is on. So we want to record history as well. The first one, let's do this one. It's going to be your rail cross section. And make sure, and it tells it's unable to alter the shape on the rail, and this is nothing wrong, this is a rail, this is cross section. So the things you might experience is you have been grouping this dot or this point to this circle, so then the computer have no idea what that is. All we need to do is ungroup. Alright, so let's do one more time. Sweep one rail, we're gonna go from this one to this one to this one. And make sure they all align correctly. I like them to align to the place I don't see as much. So I want them to align to the bottom. Make sure record history is on. So we get our first one. And we want to do the same to the rest of it.Now we have it done, we can now to edit a little bit. For example, we're gonna move, since we have a record history, we're gonna move this up a little bit. So that will give us this really nice curve here. If you like it, have it more solid, we can also do is we can go ahead to select those control point over there and bring this down to the bottom. So that way you will have it solid all the way to the bottom. So that kind of give you two options to have. The second one, we also want this one going up a little bit or something like this. So now let's take a look on the top view. If you come over to the top view and then you look at it, you feel like, okay, you need more space. You can also move this one up a little bit or something like that to change the gap that you have in the middle. And after that, all you need to do is put the stone right in the middle. Make sure they all have a good contact so you will have a better casting.I hope you enjoyed the tutorial today. If you'd like to know more about a stone setting, don't forget to click the link below that has a whole class with a bunch of different type of a stone setting for you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe it. Don't forget to click on the little bell so you will get the notification whenever I have the new one coming up. Thank you and see you next time.